Butler will inbound for West Virginia, and this is Bryant. Ruoff held scoreless in the first half. Butler was not. He had a nice offensive performance. Ruoff, nice cut to the bucket.
That is a senior play right there. Understanding the first 20 minutes he did not score, highly unusual. So what does he do? He makes a nice aggressive move to the rim, Mike, because if you see it go through, you start to feel a little bit better about yourself.
He had been 0-for-4 to that point. A runner for Summers.
He and Austin Freeman give John Thompson III about 29 points per game. They were a combined 2-for-8. So another guy who steps up and wants to get started early here in the second half.
So both teams looking to their offensive stars early in the second 20 minutes. Butler, good hustle to get it back. And Ruoff will try for his first outside shot and miss. Freeman and Summers, as you pointed out, combined for nearly 29 points together on the season. 8 so far tonight after Summers scored the last bucket. Monroe just keeps working inside. Foul would be on Smith, only his first.
Well, this is a nice aggressive move. It's a good contest initially by Wellington Smith, who's giving up some inches. If I had one criticism for a guy like Greg Monroe, who I thoroughly enjoy watching play, I almost feel sometimes like he could be more selfish and assertive when he does touch the basketball to score it.
And maybe a little more aggressive inside. He doesn't seem to go up as strong as you would expect a guy who was 6'11", 250.
It's, you know, the Princeton offense is sort of a read react. So you have to have a feel, as you mentioned, his basketball IQ. But again, he's got so much skill. And I know he's a terrific passer. He's unselfish. He doesn't care about how many shots. But what you have to understand as a young player is how much value you add to Georgetown as a scorer.
Sure.
And go ahead and be assertive.
He has already been the Big East Player of the Week 3 times. Ruoff goes down the lane. Beautiful feed.
Now, you know, I think people can see the identity of West Virginia as toughness and defense and rebounding. They're at their best when they are moving bodies, moving the ball, and passing it. They are a motion offense team as well.
Beautiful scoop shot by Wright. Holy cow. How do those things not go in?
You should get points for degree of difficulty.
Absolutely.
Can you make that a 3-pointer instead of a 2?
Bryant trying to go inside. Ebanks. A little fadeaway jump shot by Ebanks.
Well, that's a nice looking move. He's so lean. Didn't get pushed off his move at all.
West Virginia extending that lead. Summers hits a 3. DeJuan Summers, a 44.8% long-range shooter, gets a good look.
He's a star. You are not going to hold DeJuan Summers down. He's got the athleticism and the basketball skill set to dominate.
You just expect a kid with his talent to just start taking over games all the time.
Well, in conference plays, 50% from the floor. You mentioned his percentage overall. In conference, he's been 50% from deep, 78% free throw shooter. He's a pretty good option on the offensive end.
Yes, he is. Mountaineers by 4, but here's a steal. Right? Boy, great defense by the Mountaineers. That just hustle could have easily been a bucket for Georgetown, and Bryant would just not give up.
See, now in tape, you just play that over and over for Chuck Bryant and say, see what persistence does. A little mishandled by Chris Wright, but sprint to the ball. Good things happen when you are the assertive one.
Third foul is called on Jesse Sapp.
Georgetown shows a possession of 2-3 zone here.
Squandered opportunities on the run for the Georgetown Hoyas. Freeman gives it up to Wright, and he'll pull up for three. And at halfway down, Rule off with the rebound. West Virginia trying to run. Four on two. Bryant down the lane. He had it knocked away. Outstanding defense by Freeman. Back the other way. Monroe kicks it out. Freeman. Racehorse basketball, and no one getting anything out of it. Good skip pass by Ruoff. Oh, pretty drive by Butler. Deshaun Butler has been the offense for the Mountaineers tonight.
Well, how fast to the rim and the ability to adjust and keep under control and understand where you are. At that speed, that is tough.
17 points for Butler on 7 out of 10 shooting from the floor. The West Virginia junior making a difference here on the road as West Virginia goes for the upset. Get ready to text, you are the judge.
Well, how about that? Next generation, no representation of the distaff side on that graphic. There is a woman, Gretchen Blyler, okay? She's got a move called the Crippler. I think that's what we call Franny for Schiller. Don't we call Franny that?
Well, you got to credit West Virginia's defense. They have been tough tonight against a Georgetown offense that is based on execution and precision, and West Virginia shut them down.
Yeah, Georgetown is third in the league in field goal percentage as a team, 48%. It has been a struggle for them to generate any kind of flow. John Thompson talks a ton about scoring out of flow. There has been very little of that for the Hoyas.
And West Virginia allowing only 40% shooting by its opponents. Ruoff, who has been off all night long, has one layup. Flowers with the rebound, kicks it out to Bryant, and the freshman knocks down another three. Big night for freshman players for the Mountaineers on the road.
Young man looks poised and confident on the catch.
11 points, 3 out of 4. Ruoff with the steal all the way in, missed the shot. Knocked out of bounds. Georgetown fans really upset. They thought there was a foul on the play that went uncalled, and West Virginia ends up with a basketball.
Well, again, we get slow-mo.
Well, I'm not sure. Don't think so.
Bobby Donato was in perfect position. What I love about Ruoff is the guy is struggling. And he's got 5 assists. He hasn't been able to put the ball in the ocean, but he's got 5 assists. He's still guarding, and he gives up his body on that play.
Absolutely. 42-33, West Virginia by 9. It's their biggest lead. They're trying to build on it. Butler goes baseline. Pull-up jumper. Got it. No. Offensive foul on Butler, pushed off to get free. Oh, that would have been huge. Would have been an 11-point lead, and he would have been going to the free throw line, and a wry laugh from Bob Huggins. Oh, that's not much.
That's not a Big East foul.
No. No, that's not a Church League foul. Right down the lane with a miss jam. There is a foul on Summers.
Look out. Okay, now this guy reminds me a little bit of McGrady, because sometimes I think he shoots too many jump shots. Here's why you want him attacking the rim. Look at that. Get out of my way.
Smith prevents the jam.
Now, you know what? I always get the sense, because Deshaun Butler closed out on him. And I felt like his closeout was impacted by the call on the opposite end.
I did too.
He went out lackadaisical, kind of put his hand. You better go down in a stance on DeJuan Summers, or he's going to make you look foolish.
West Virginia substitution number 22.
Ruoff will check back in as Wellington Smith picked up his second personal foul. He'll get a breather. And Summers knocks that one down. 42-35. I think the fans here at the Verizon Center keep expecting Georgetown to make a big run, and they've been unable to do it so far. Bryant can't penetrate, and that's going to be a travel on Deshaun Butler.
Okay, so now Deshaun Butler's got to get himself under control here, okay, because that's three possessions. You know, I got on him for his closeout. He went hard. It was a miscommunication. So a bad call, bad closeout, and now a turnover. Now watch, it's right here, okay, and then they're going to try to close out in this direction. And it's just a little miscommunication. They were closing out hard, but not under control. And it's one of the hardest things in college basketball to do. Close out to prevent the drive and still contest jump shots.
Now they are questioning the shot clock because it did not reset, apparently.
State, wow, are they making some steps.
It's going to be an offensive foul against Georgetown. Greg Monroe will be called for his second. So Georgetown with a chance to cut into that lead turns it over on the turnover.
They call him on the hook there. That's tough.
Yes, it is. There've been three calls in a row. You'd have to question just how serious they were. Jones in for West Virginia. He's number five. Flowers is in. Ruoff goes baseline, out of control. Kicks it back out to Butler, in and out. Had it halfway down. Summers picked up by Ruoff. This is right. Good dish down to Monroe, and Monroe gets it off. Basket counts, and the foul.
This game is about toughness. That's all it comes down to. Both teams are guarding really hard. Things are hard on the offensive end to come by. How about the spacing? There's so little there. That's 6'10"
That's
making
right.
That pass.
Flowers gets the foul. Wright will go to the line. Chance for the three-point play the old-fashioned way.
How does that guy make the pass between that many blue jerseys that are that long?
Great vision. A little Georgetown run here, 42-38.
This is a toughness game, Mike. Who can make the fewest mistakes and try to generate quality possessions as we approach the midway point in the second half?
Let's see if Ruoff can get on track. They could really use his offense right now. Butler, a little hesitation, knocks it down anyway. Big shot for Deshaun Butler, who had missed three or four in a row and looked a little bit unsure. He has 20 points. Good defense by West Virginia. Summers double teamed as he got to the baseline.
Kevin Jones should get some love. That was excellent help defense.
That's been Bob Huggins' trademark his entire career. Basket, and the foul is Monroe starting to take over. He goes right down the lane.
They get him isolated at the top of the key, and they draw big defenders away from the rim. And you better have your feet ready to go. This is a little mismatch. Bryan up at the top. Greg Monroe says, I don't care if he's a guard. I don't care if I'm on the box or at the high post. I'm going right at this guy.
Don't even care if his nickname is Truck.
Yeah.
A pretty stroke by Monroe from the free throw line. Lead is back to four. Georgetown showing zone. Smith out of the corner. With Todd, nearly lost control of that dribble. Both teams trying to crank up the defensive intensity. With Todd, backdoor cut. Scoop, and he made it. Outstanding athletic move by With Todd.
You're running your offense through the best player on the floor right now, Greg Monroe.
10-2 run for Georgetown, and they have made it a two-point game.
Greg Monroe starting to get busy on the offensive end. He can score for himself. He can be a facilitator. At 6'10", little backdoor cut, bounce pass on the money would tie to spin.
The Hoyas right now as close as they have been since it was 24-22 in the first half. 11 minutes, 39 seconds to go in this one. Mike Patrick, Doris Burke, glad you could join us for the Big East from the Verizon Center in Washington, D.C. Georgetown making its run and have closed within two.
When they're good, this young man, Greg Monroe, is generally speaking getting lots of touches, facilitating the Hoya offense. His plus minus is 80. So that means when he's on the floor, they're 80 points better than their opponent.
Pretty good. Ruoff, who has been held to one bucket. That was a layup. Butler, too strong. Rebounded Jason Clark.
I misstated that. They score. They've scored more than 80 points than their opponent when he's on the floor. So let's see, do they go through him again? He wants it. See, now that time he's being aggressive and saying to the point guard, hey, give me the ball.
Smith with the rebound off the miss, kicks it out to Rule. Smith down the lane into a double team offensive foul. Wellington Smith out of control, picked up his third personal foul. Winter X follows our broadcast here from the Verizon Center. We have 10 minutes and 45 seconds to go. We explained the Hoya Saxa nickname for you, but here's the other question. Why do they have a bulldog for a mascot? Why not a rock?
What rocks?
Maybe it's what a bulldog. Yeah, he's a little feisty tonight. He's ready to go.
That is the West Virginia box, and he's really taking a disliking to that. That's
what
a well-trained
do.
Puppy boy.
Georgetown down by two. Monroe at the high post trying to run the offense from there. Clark for three. No. Well, Georgetown, no offensive rebounds to speak of the entire ball game, and this is not a good rebounding clock.
When you're 2 for 12, you could use some offensive boards. Those are long boards.
Still trying to get Ruoff free for something. Flowers lost it on the way up. Loose ball. Here comes Georgetown. Clark on the run. Kicks it into the corner to Freeman. Too strong on his shot. One and done again.
Make it 2 for 13. Another long rebound. Georgetown has 5 offensive rebounds on the evening.
This is like the stretch in the first half where they had so many opportunities and just couldn't convert. Pretty drive down the lane. Deshaun Butler. And Deshaun with 22 points on the night. He is a very accomplished offensive player. Bank too strong by Freeman. Ruoff posting up into the lane. Kicks it back outside to Flowers. Had a 12-footer. Missed the shot. Follow is good.
Good persistence. That should have been Ruoff's 7th assist.
Reach and foul on Ruoff.
So you got to believe, as well as Marquette's playing, they're 5-0 in Big East Conference. They have the toughest out. Franny Fraschilla touched on this at the half. They have a brutal out, Marquette. So this is great that they're getting off to a great start. But the likely top three finishing teams in the Big East, Pitt, Syracuse and Louisville, before it's all said and done, might finish 1, 2, 3. And Bobby Huggins has those two teams twice.
Billy Hahn says Louisville's playing, in his opinion, as well as anybody in the entire country right now.
Yeah, Terrence Williams, Big East Player of the Week.
Assistant coach Eric Martin for West Virginia wanted to say hi to his daughter, Amaya. She's back home in Dayton, Ohio. Eric, of course, played for Bob Huggins at Cincinnati, where he earned his chops. 49-44, West Virginia continues to lead. Every time Georgetown makes a run, they come up just a little bit short. Ruoff, he's not going to miss him forever. Alex Ruoff drains the three, his first bucket outside of one layup, and quickly the lead grows to eight.
Just 2 for 9. The majority of his shots, as you see there, come from three-point percentage distance.
That's a great thing about shooters, though, Doris. No matter how much they miss, they're going to keep shooting it.
Yeah, they always believe that the next one's going to go down. That takes great confidence. You're on the road, you struggle. But what has he done to keep his head in the game, Mike? He's defended. He has 6 assists on the night. He hasn't quit. That's a senior who's been through the wars of the Big East and knows you just keep playing.
We approach the 8-minute mark. Ruoff. And shooters, after they hit that one, really get psyched up. They start feeling it. Now Ebanks turns it over. Bob Huggins says you just got to calm down.
Slow down. He looked like he was in a rush.
Crowd very restless here at the Verizon Center, expecting better things to happen for the Hoyas. They have not yet. Sapp, who hasn't had much of an offensive impact. Summers, on the outside shot, just not going, and there's a foul on Georgetown, trying to get the rebound. Freeman holds. Fascinated by the idea that fans are going to be able to text message and determine who wins the big air for the snowmobile.
Sal Masekela, what would the X game be without him?
Ruoff, 5 points. But Doris, you pointed out the fact that he's done the other things even in the midst of a shooting slump tonight. And by half, Georgetown, 16 turnovers, and that exceeds their season average. And after they got within 2 points, they've missed their last 5 shots. Smith, top of the circle, a shooter's best friend. That's a two. And it's 54-44. West Virginia on a 9-0 run, and they have amassed their biggest lead. Wright cuts into it with a layup.
That's twice now. Chris Wright has simply made a cut off the high post. Greg Monroe has put the ball softly off the floor. He's had to be creative, Chris Wright, at the rim. But you know what? You've got to start getting some stops. West Virginia doing a nice job running the motion offense.
Rayshon Butler in and out. Good hustle by West Virginia. Wellington Smith picks up the loose ball. And a fresh shot clock for the Mountaineers. And the clock is their friend right now. Bryant cuts down the left side of the lane and draws a foul. I'm very, very impressed by this freshman point guard.
Now this is a kid who's coming off a game against South Florida where he's completely ineffective in the second half, so much so that he had to sit the last 9.5 minutes. Missoula has done the best job he can in trying to talk Chuck Bryant through situations. Bobby Huggins' expectations are high, but on the road, he's been terrific.
Butler out of the corner. Bingo! Deshaun Butler. And it's 57-46, West Virginia. They can smell it. And the Mountaineers with quite a few fans here tonight as well. Foul on Smith. That is his fourth. And Monroe will go to the line. Young man out of New Orleans. And here comes Kevin Jones. And Smith will come out with those 4 fouls. Every point becomes precious now as we hit 16 and counting in this game, in West Virginia up by 11.
Butler's a guy who's had 25 plus four times already coming into this. He is capable of this kind of explosion.
Shot clock at 10. Ruoff wants a clear out.
Great movement, great spacing. You're forcing Georgetown to defend. Got to go at the rim now.
Ebanks. Offensive rebound, but Flowers got it by pushing off.
Georgetown player, one of the best little men to ever play in the NBA, Allen Iverson.
Unless you irritate him by asking him to practice.
We're talking about practice.
Now, this would be an absolutely monumental road win. I mean, first of all, you've got to value home games in this conference because it's hard enough to win on the road. West Virginia's been tougher, it seems, all night. They've had a response for every Georgetown run. Do the Hoyas have another one in them?
Mountaineers lead by 9. Ruoff had the shot. Passed in and then goes right down the lane. That's a veteran move by Alex Ruoff.
Spacing allows that to happen. Terrific job running their offense here in the second half by West Virginia.
Summers, fadeaway jumper. For one and done. And last touch by Flowers. Georgetown is going to have a tough time in this league if they can't rebound any better than this.
Yeah, I agree. It's been a bugaboo all year long. The bench problem they fixed with Jason Clark and Omar Watad. The rebounded, they haven't.
Out of control, right travels.
Alex Ruoff has shown great mental toughness. Watch him at the top of the key. He's going to simply go off the bounce. Another poor closeout. And when you don't close out under control, so he's thinking contest. Now the guy struggled. So what does Ruoff do? He looks a little like his buddy Joe Alexander.
Yes,
on
does.
That move right there.
Got some hops. Ruoff contested inside, fouled. Well, West Virginia is just out hustling Georgetown, and they really have done it all night long, and you got to give them a lot of credit for coming in here.
It just feels like they've been a little bit tougher, a little bit quicker to the ball, more deflections. I mean, boy, does that personify this guy right here?
Absolutely. Earlier today, he was bemoaning the fact that he's playing so many young kids, and it makes it very, very difficult. Flowers, offensive rebound, and the Mountaineers are just killing Georgetown on the boards. But bemoaning the fact that he's playing so many young guys, they're not able to hit shots, but that's the growth process that you go through as a coach with a young team.
Yeah, yeah. I'm not sure any coach is happy. We had Michigan State's Tom Izzo. He was on like a 7-game win streak, and he wasn't happy. You can see why he got picked off last night against Northwestern. I don't think late January, early February is an easy time on any coach.
I don't know how they do it, really.
No.
Flowers at the line. Georgetown needs some buckets, and they need them in a hurry. And Flowers going to be called for a hold. That's going to be 4 on Flowers. Wellington Smith already has 4 for West Virginia, and not a whole lot of depth for Bob Huggins to go to. And Freeman will go to the line. He's hit all 4 tries from the free throw line today and has 6 points.
See more of West Virginia space the floor, use that motion offense. You noted this about the 12-minute mark. The clock, the time is their friend. Keep that clock moving. Keep your offense crisp, hard line cuts.
One of the problems they have is they are not a great free throw shooting team. So when you try to spread the floor and try to draw fouls, you have to be able to go to the free throw line and convert, and they only shoot 65%.
Yeah, then it becomes a coach's decision. At what point do you start making this game longer?
Steal by Monroe. Bryant is back, and they're going to call Bryant for a blocking foul. Basket counts. That's four on Bryant, and West Virginia getting in an awful lot of foul trouble right now.
6'11", 250 pounds in the passing lane, uses that strong left hand of his. How about the ability to attack and adjust his body against a smaller Bryant? One, two, hard, long steps at the rim, the soft touch finger roll. That's Gervin-esque.
Yeah,
right there.
He's pretty good.
Wow.
This kid is a keeper. 59-52, still time for Georgetown. In and out on the free throw.
Still say this game is about toughness. I mean, it's just felt like that all night long. This is a very typical Big East battle here. You got to grind to win and try to win when you don't have your best.
If you're West Virginia, you cannot completely shut down your offense. You want to take time, but you want to score like that. Kevin Jones with a baseline jumper, maybe a lot quicker than Bob Huggins would have liked, but he made it.
That's a no, no, no. Yes!
Summers missed. Monroe trying to keep it alive. Got to beat the 10-second count here, and they do. And a foul. It's 61-52. Let's check in with Dari Nelka. Dari Abraham Lincoln.
Go ahead, Mr. Patrick, understanding what that friend request means. You're a next generation kind of guy.
Not quite.
Boy, made free throws. You mentioned it. It's not been a strong point for West Virginia. It might have to be over the final 3.5 minutes.
Georgetown with a big advantage in free throws, 14 out of 19. West Virginia only 4 out of 6. But right now, the Mountaineers with the advantage. West Virginia basketball.
See, what West Virginia, when you have a 10-point lead, you're operating with the advantage. That's Mike Stevens having a conversation, letting Georgetown know what's what. But you understand what they're thinking. You're understanding Georgetown. John Thompson's team is thinking quick possessions.
Yeah.
So you're more alert. Your hands are really active, as they have been all night for Bobby Huggins.
18 Georgetown turnovers. That's been the difference in this ball game.
Yeah, they came in averaging just over 13. They're usually terrific with the ball.
Part of that has got to go to the credit of the West Virginia defense, but part of it is just mishandling the basketball by Georgetown. Butler kicks it out to Jones. He's short on the jumper. Offensive rebound to follow. No. I'm sure Bob Huggins would have rather seen the ball come out just like that. And it's West Virginia's toughness on the boards that has made a difference in this ballgame, and Monroe commits a foul.
That's teammates bailing you out, because I thought that first shot was a bad shot. There were 17 seconds. That was about to be a bad possession.
Yeah.
But because your teammates went after the glass and bailed you out, got yourself an extra possession and now some free throws.
Ruoff, by far the best free throw shooter, 79%. And, of course, the guy that they would always like to have going to the line in these situations.
West Virginia plus 10 on the glass, make it plus 11.
Mm-hmm. Offensive rebound. 14-6, a big advantage for West Virginia in that department. And a lot of offensive rebounders just wanting it.
That's correct. That's why I was saying toughness. This is about toughness. This is about being assertive. Who wants it more? John Thompson II went to his guys last week. This is the father, Big Papa, and said, rebounding's about want to, guys. Let's stop getting outboarded.
But right now, all the want to has been in blue and gold. Butler with a runner. Got it. And the Mountaineers looking more and more like a team that may have to be contended with, even with all that youth. Summers trying to make something happen, got to the baseline. And as long as the clock has stopped, Georgetown has hope. 2:22 to go. But they're down by 13. And Butler now with 27 points. That last foul, by the way, was on Thurman, his first. So Butler with 27, only one off of his career high. And the last three games, he has averaged better than 20 points a game. So he has been the scoring star for this ball club. Finally, a rebound for Georgetown, and they get a follow to pay it off.
Got to get scores to get your pressure set. Nice job spacing, good attack.
Pretty move by Jones ahead of the pack. Or Ebanks, and he was able to lay it in for the two for the West Virginia Mountaineers. And he comes up limping and badly.
He makes a terrific move.
I don't know if he hyperextended it.
It almost looks like it's cramping.
It almost does, and that would be a tremendous break for the Mountaineers if it is a cramp. It is warming because those will go away as much as they hurt. A serious hamstring pull is going to take a lot longer, and they need that young man in the lineup. And the way they're stretching him out, it does look like a cramp, and that is very good news. Ebanks 9.7 boards tonight.
8 free throws allow you to set your pressure.
Butler trying to beat the double team and does. Kicks it ahead to Ruoff. And the veteran says, let's take it back outside and work the clock down to a minute and 45. This is all West Virginia really needs to do. They do not have to score. Bryant, and that's goaltending.
It's close. See, if it hits the backboard, then it's an automatic goaltend. It doesn't have to be on its way down if it hits the backboard. That was close.
Yes, it was. I don't think the referees like that rule. It brings too much judgment into the game when they may not have good angles to make those calls. I think they'd rather have something a little bit simpler.
I think so much of officiating, obviously, is about angles.
Boy, they're on their feet, the West Virginia fans, and why not? They have come in here and turned in quite a performance. If they hang on to win, they will go 3-2 in the Big East, and Georgetown will fall to 2-3. And if you can steal a win on the road in this league against a quality opponent, you've done something. Winter X Games 13, when we're done. From beautiful Colorado. Are you an Aspen kind of girl?
Well, it's beautiful at this time of year. It's basketball season. I don't want to work that event because I've missed too many games.
Offensive rebound followed by Monroe. Monroe continues to keep it alive. And out of bounds at the 107 mark. We have 106 to go. And the crowd here at the Verizon Center starting to work its way toward the exits. Be a very pleasant trip for West Virginia back home.
How far a ride is that, my West Virginia friend?
4.5 hours. Everything from here is 4.5 hours. I have to go back to Duke tomorrow. That's 4.5 hours.
Up from North Carolina. You've been a busy man. Back to back to back.
I did. I have burned some serious petroleum products this week. Monroe kicks it back outside. Summers. And West Virginia now working on the clock under a minute to go. Nice dish inside for the jam. Wellington Smith from Ruoff, who has shown you a complete game tonight, even in the midst of shooting struggles. Ruoff now with 8 assists. Boy, hats off to the Mountaineers. This was a quality win for them. I'm impressed, Doris.
I'm really impressed. I said all night that this was a toughness win for West Virginia. They were tougher, stronger to the basketball, more tips. And as the Hoya fans made their way out, boy, there's pockets of yellow shirts everywhere in this building.
Bob Huggins cheering on his troops as West Virginia has increased the lead to 17. Of course, it was much closer than this. Very competitive throughout, but the Mountaineers are going to knock off the number 14 team in the country. The final score, West Virginia 75, Georgetown 58. For Doris Burke and the rest of our ESPN crew, this is Mike Patrick saying so long from Washington, D.C. If you'd like more on tonight's game, you can join us on ESPN News for a post-game extra. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Now we take you to Aspen, Colorado, and start our coverage of Winter X 13.